Well, Caama Radio was the first Aboriginal group in Australia to secure a community broadcasting licence with the purpose of providing Aboriginal people in Central Australia with radio programs produced by Aboriginal people in Aboriginal languages and English. NITV's Steve Mungindi headed down to the Caama studios in Alice Springs to bring us this story.
It doesn't matter what country or culture you're from, we all want to know what's going on in our communities. The Central Australian Aboriginal Media Association, also known as Caama, has been doing exactly that for the past 30 years.
Luckily for me, you know, I grew up with my culture and language, so I've always had that in my life as well. So that's sort of one of the reasons why I'm here as well, to be able to get that language of my people and a lot of people around the centre out to the wider community. And
we're at Bookaby 199.9 Sujuna Family Mob Nagrenya 102.9. We're at. Hope you're having a lovely day as well.
Trainee broadcaster Michaela Simpson is the youngest and the first Aboriginal woman to be on the board of the CBAA, the Community Broadcasting Association of Australia.
There's so many media outlets out there, commercial community, that don't have a concept or a grasp or a full idea or vision of what is happening within our communities across the whole country. Ultimately, we're not heard. We're still fighting the same battles that our elders have been fighting for however many years. You know, it's absolutely crazy. But I think having this platform has definitely opened up a world to not only our mob but to the wider community as well. They've gotten to experience and listen to our stories, hear our struggles and feel our passion.
With almost two decades under his belt at Caama, the station manager Jerry Lyons, better known as the G-Man.
And a big welcome to the Impaja Cup crew, NRL, the Parramatta Eels are in town. Good morning to NITV, they're in the house of Caama. Good morning.
Gives us an insight of the passion of the Caama trainees.
It's a 7 day a week, 24 hour a day thing. They learn about politics nationally, they learn about themselves, they start to stand up with pride and with that knowing that what they're doing makes a difference, that they become mentors for others out there that want to also get involved and have something to say.
Whether it's in radio or TV, we still continue to bring you the latest news from the oldest culture. Steve Mungindi in the Caama studios in Alice Springs for NITV News.